नमस्ते। आई लिव इन गोरखपुर फ्रॉम द फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक एमपी इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डायग्नोस्टिक एंड कम्युनिटी हेल्थ इन द डिसिप्लिन ऑफ कार्डियोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेशन दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर जनरल रेडिएशन सेकेंड एंड रेडियोग्राफिक टेक्निक ऑफ होल बॉडी फॉर डीसीआरटी सेकेंड इंस्ट्रूमेंट। आई एम फ्रॉम जयपुर विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैड डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्टिविटीज व्यू। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द रिस्ट कार्पल टनल व्यू। व्हाट इज द कार्पल टनल व्यू, व्हाई इट इज यूज्ड। कार्पल टनल व्यू इज एन एक्सियल प्रोजेक्शन टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट द मीडियल एंड लेटरल प्रोमेंसेस एंड द कॉनकेविटी। ओके, इंडिकेशन दिस कार्पल टनल व्यू इज परफॉर्म्ड हाउएवर इट कैन बी यूटिलाइज्ड टू इन्वेस्टिगेट द पोटेंशियल हुक ऑफ हैमेट टिश्यू फॉर्म एंड ट्रेपेजियम फ्रैक्चर। ओके, द पोजिशनिंग ऑफ पेशेंट। पेशेंट स्टैंड विद द बैक फेसिंग द टेबल। फेसिंग द टेबल, ओके, फेसिंग टेबल मीन प्रोजेक्शन इज पी। ओके, पामर सरफेस ऑफ हैंड इज प्लेस्ड इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द फैसेट। ओके, विच इज प्लेस्ड एट द टेबल मार्क। रिस्ट इज डोर्सिफ्लेक्शन अप्रोक्सीमेटली 135 डिग्री मेकिंग द कार्पल एंड मेटाकार्पल लिफ्ट अवे फ्रॉम द फैसेट। ओके, नेक्स्ट वन इज द टेक्निकल फैक्टर। टेक्निकल फैक्टर इट इज द एक्सियल प्रोजेक्शन। द सेंट्रल पॉइंट इज मिड कार्पल रीजन। द सेंट्रल रे इज वर्टिकल एंड विल बी सेंटर्ड टू द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ द डोर्सिफ्लेक्शन। ओके, कोलिमेशन। लेटरली इट इंक्लूड्स द स्किन मार्जिन, डोर्सल टू द स्किन मार्जिन, वेंट्रल टू द कार्पो मेटाकार्पल जॉइंट। ओरिएंटेशन। द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ कैसेट शुड पोर्ट्रेट डिटेक्टर साइज दैट इज यूज्ड इज 8x10 inches और 18x24 centimeter। एक्सपोजर। एक्सपोजर दैट इज यूज्ड इन द रिस्ट जॉइंट और कार्पल टनल व्यू। द फैक्टर इज 44 to 50 kV एंड द एमईएस शुड बी 2 to 6 mm। ओके, एसआईटी। सोर्स टू इमेज सेपरेशन शुड यूज इज 100 cm। ग्रिड, नो ग्रिड यूज because less radiation exposure factors are used. Image technical evaluation, there should be a clear outline of the ventral aspect of the carpal bone with no superimposition. Or this is a very specialized and slightly outdated position, yet it is not important or it is not performed. Okay, it is in projection. And sitting down, we can take up image after seated the patient in dorsiflexion, after in the supine position, in the seated sitting position or supine position. Okay, so this is the carpal tunnel view. Next is the scaphoid view, PA scaphoid view. It is a part of the four view series of the scaphoid, wrist and the surrounding carpal bone. Perform the PA view. PA view can open the refer to and video indication. This view aims to show the scaphoid in its anatomical position, hence allowing the visualization of initiatable subtle distal, middle and proximal fractures. Patient position. Patient is seated alongside the table. The affected arm, if possible, is flexed at 90 degrees, so the arm and the wrist can rest on the table. The affected hand is placed palm down on the image receptor with hand in ulnar deviation. In ulnar deviation means it is the radius or this is the ulna. So ulnar deviation. Okay, this is the ulnar deviation. Ulnar deviation. Okay. Shoulder, elbow, and wrist should all be in the transverse plane. Perpendicular to the central axis. The wrist and elbow should be at shoulder height. which makes the radius and umbrella parallel. Okay, technical factor or exposure factor. It is a PA projection, centering point anatomically central as like any other view of this PA view. Okay, collimation laterally to the skin margin, distal to the midway up to margin, metacarpal. Proximal to the include one quarter, means one quarter, 1/4 of the radius and ulna. Orientation should portrait detector size that is used is 8 by 10 inches or 18 by 24 centimeter. Exposure factor used is 44 to 50 kV and MA should be in the 3 to 8. Okay, SID. SID that is used is 100 centimeter grid, no grid is used. Okay. Image technical evaluation. Hand is in alert deviation with little superimposition over the scaphoid bone, minor superimposition of the metacarpal bone. Articulation between the distal radiation and ulna is open or has little superimposition. Concavity of the metacarpal shaft is equal. Okay. So this is in this session we had discussed about the carport tunnel view. This is a specialized in this specific view, okay, to see the fracture of the hooks in the piciform or piciform trapezium, okay. Or after that, we will study about the scaphoid view that is in radial ulnar projection, okay. Thank you. This session is over. Okay. Namaste. Our today's lesson is just lateral decubitus view. So, lateral decubitus view of the chest is a specialized projection rarely utilized with the commonality of CT. It is chiefly used in pediatric population. So, the view, lateral decubitus view. And specialized projection which is really utilized. Okay? In some special cases. Okay? Our chest lateral decubitus view is an important view for chest examination that is in radiographic technique of full body course. Okay? Indication undertaken to demonstrate small pleural effusion. So it is used to demonstrate small pleural effusion or for the investigation of pneumothorax and air trapping due to inhaled foreign body. Okay, inhaled foreign body. So next, the patient position. Patient position. In the patient position, the patient is lying either left lateral or right lateral on a trolley on top of the radiolucent sponge or pillow. Okay. When investigating pneumothorax, the site of interest should be up. Okay. When investigating pleural effusion, then the site of interest should be down. Okay. When we are going to check the fluid level, small fluid level, then the site that is in touch should be in the same side. The detector is placed landscape posterior to the patient, running parallel with the long axis of the thorax. Okay, so the patient's hand should be raised to avoid superimposing on the region of interest. Leg may be flexed for any. So patient's hand should be raised to avoid superimposition. There should be no superimposition on the region of interest. Leg may be flexed for balance in a lateral decubitus. Okay, rotation of shoulder or pelvis should be minimized. Okay, so there should not any rotation of shoulder or pelvis, patient should be changed into a hospital gown with radiopaque item removed, like bag, zipper, and any other metallic object that is present in the chest region. X-ray is taken in full inspiration. So ask to the patient to hold a breath in the inspiration. Okay. So the technical exposure factor. So this is the lateral that you lay in the lateral position, the centering point, mid sternal plane, mid deep sternum at the level of T7. Okay. Collimation laterally to include both lungs. Okay. So the both lungs are covered in the collimation or in the field side. So previous to the apex. Okay. So above the apex. Okay. Inferior to the first two diaphragmatic region. Okay. Okay. So orientation of the cassette should portrait. Detector size that is used is 14 by 17 inches or in centimeter 35 by 43 centimeter. Exposure that is used in the rectimeter view is 60 to 70 kbp. Okay, and the MES used is in the range of 16 to 30. SID, so image detector distance is 100 centimeter. Or next is a grid. Grid is used in this projection. Next is the image technical evaluation. A marker annotating horizontal beam decorators should always be present. So marker is should always be present with the side of interest clearly labeled. Okay. The marker is made by the lead that is clearly labeled left or right. Okay. The entire lung field should be visible from the apices. Okay. Down to the lateral CP angle, costofendic angle. The chin should not be superimposing any structure. Okay. Any structure. Minimal to no superimposition of the scapula border on the lung field. Okay. Next is the sternoclavicular joints are equal or equidistant apart. Okay. The clavicle is in the same horizontal plane. A minimum of 10 posterior ribs is visualized above the diaphragm. The ribs and thoracic cage are seen only faintly over the heart. Okay. So we are going to visualize or detect any abnormality like pneumothorax or pleural effusion. So the ribs of thoracic cage are seen only faintly over the heart. Clear vascular marking of the lungs should be visible for the vessel. Okay. Practical points. In the context of inhaled foreign body, bilateral decubitus lateral view should be performed. Okay. Allowing for adequate assessment of any air trapping. Okay. Next one is patient with obstructive foreign body will not have a collapsed lung, however will manifest hyperlucency of the dependent lung. Okay. Ensure the patient is carefully rested against the wall detector and at no risk of the falling. Okay. So patient should be in comfortable position. The rotation of our chest radiograph can stimulate common pathological process and make it hard to produce an appropriate diagnosis. Okay. The sternoclavicular joint, SC joint, are a sound indicator for a positional rotation. If one sternoclavicular joint is noted wider than the other, that respected side needs to be rotated towards the image receptor to correct rotation. Okay. Patients with a long standing history of emphysema or COPD will have abnormally long lungs compared to the general population. Remember this when collimating superior to inferior. Okay. साइड मार्कर प्लेसमेंट इज इम्पेरेटिव. पेशेंट कैन हैव कंसिलेटरी कंडीशन दैट मिमिक अ मिरर डैमेज. ओके सो रिमेंबर टू इट इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट एक्सप्लेन टू योर पेशेंट व्हाट द प्रोसीजर इज what the procedure is going by you. That is, ask them to take a breath and hold it. Many times that gives the patient time to prepare and result in a better recovery and therefore a high quality radiograph. Always remember to tell the patient to breathe again, because some patients hold the breath and doesn't remember to breathe again. So always it is a responsibility of a radiographic or technologist. Okay, I think you all satisfied with the session. Thank you. The session is over. I think this session is very much useful for you or very interesting for you. I think you are satisfied with this session. If you have any queries, then put it into the comment box. I will resolve it later. Thank you. This session is over. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0. Jayati Vidyapeeth Women's University.